When I'm helping teams get started with quantitative UX research, I'm often asked this question.
Is it okay to collect quantitative metrics during qualitative usability testing studies?
The short answer is yes, but you have to treat those numbers differently than you would if you had actually run a quantitative study. And that's because qualitative and quantitative studies have very different goals, so they have to be structured differently. In qualitative studies, we're trying to gather insights. We want to know what works, what doesn't, and why. In quantitative user testing, we're gathering metrics. We want to know, for example, how long it takes people on average to complete a task. As a result of these two very different goals, we have to structure and run these two types of usability studies very differently. For example, we need way more participants in a quantitative study than we would need for a qualitative one. So because of these differences, it just really is not reasonable to try to blend your quantitative and your qualitative studies together. You have to decide, am I doing quant or am I doing qual? If you decide to do a qualitative study, you can collect quantitative metrics during that study if you want to, but you won't report them in the same way. For example, let's imagine that you collect time on task during a qualitative study with 5 participants. So in other words, you make a note of how much time each participant takes to complete each task. In this situation, you could not report an average time on task. You could not say something like, "We found an average time on task of 4 minutes." Why not? Because it implies that we expect that if we tested all of our real-life users, we would find a similar average time on task. But we only tested a handful of participants, so we really don't have sufficient data to make that claim. But what we can do is include individual values when we're reporting on our findings. For example, we might want to tell a story about how one participant really struggled to complete a simple task with our design, and it took her over 8 minutes to complete it. This is the key with reporting metrics collected during qualitative studies. They can help us communicate our findings when we report specific individual values. But don't report aggregated statistics like time averages or success rates. If you do want those aggregated statistics, then it might be time to run a quantitative study and not a qualitative one.